Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope that you guys are all doing really well. In terms of today's video, a couple weeks back I did a Where Are They Now video on a social media group called MAGCON, who I'm sure we all remember very fondly. It seemed like you guys enjoyed that video and I really enjoyed making it. It was kind of fun to look back at that period of everyone's lives and then like see how they grew from it and what they're doing now. So I thought it'd be fun to do this style of video again, but this time we're doing a different expired social media group and we're gonna be looking at Team 10. Of course, before we start today's video, we have to do this week's sweaty shout out. And this week it goes to the Becca B10 who sent this meme that I completely agree with. If you want to get a shout out for yourself, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel and then follow me on Instagram and DM me your favorite meme of the week and you might get chosen. Now I'm sure that everyone at some point has unfortunately come across Team 10. Maybe it was through the atrocious It's Everyday Bro music video, or maybe it was when they got on the news for setting a couch on fire in their backyard, or maybe it was when the neighbors went to the local news station because they had blasted their home's address online for a drove of 10-year-olds to stand outside and chant relentlessly until members came out of the house to take a picture with them. Maybe it was that one. However you came across Team 10, and regardless of them being absolutely insufferable at their peak, it's impossible to deny that at one point they were massive. They even at one point swung a Teen Choice Awards performance, which is terrifying to think, but it's also hilarious to look back on.
We made the song in 3 hours.
I honestly wish I was kidding when I say that Team 10 was everywhere during the summer of 2017. Like, there wasn't a single week that summer, I think, where Team 10 hadn't been mentioned on Twitter, but every single time they were mentioned, it was negative. But even though they became like the most hated social media group in the span of a few weeks, I remember back then thinking that they might last pretty long because they were one of the first serious social media groups. I do want to note here, because I'm sure that some people are going to argue that MAGCON was technically the first social media group, that I feel like MAGCON and Team 10 are slightly different, which is why I feel like Team 10 was the first of its kind versus MAGCON, which I feel like was the first in general, if that makes sense. Okay, I guess the best way to explain it is that I feel like the intentions of MAGCON and Team 10 were quite different, and you can see that in the way that the members kind of ended up. Like, I feel like for MAGCON, the members weren't joining in to just only become social media people. Like, they were just kind of going with what was developing at the time, because even back then, like, social media wasn't as, or I guess like the landscape of social media isn't what it is today. And I feel like you could see pretty early on with MAGCON that most of the members didn't want to become just social media famous, like they wanted to become singers or performers of some sort, and that's why they started breaking off so quickly and doing their own thing. Team 10, on the other hand, I feel like it's slightly different because all the members knew what they were getting into. All the members basically had the goal to become some degree of social media famous, whether it was on Instagram or YouTube or something, and that was what they wanted to do, like as a job. Like, they went into it wanting to get brand deals and grow their brand and all that kind of stuff, which I think is different from MAGCON because I feel like that wasn't what they were trying to do per se. But even with all the Team 10 members having the same end goal and wanting to do the same thing, unfortunately for them and maybe fortunately for us, it's been a very steep and very slippery slope for them since the summer of 2017. And by that, I mean there is not a single member of Team 10 that was on the team in the summer of 2017 that's still on it, except for Jake Paul. So I thought it might be interesting to check out what those members are doing right now, as well as just the current state of Team 10. Before we continue on with the video though, I did want to give a quick shout out to today's sponsor, which is Function of Beauty. As you guys know, I'm a pretty big fan of Function of Beauty's hair care. All you have to do is fill out a 2-minute quiz outlining your hair type, hair goals, and personalized preferences, and then you choose your color and fragrance, and from there, Function of Beauty delivers your customized shampoo and conditioner straight to your door. You even get to choose the name that shows up on the bottle, which is personally my favorite feature because then I get to call my hair care Function of Sweaty. Personally, my hair goals this time around were anti-aging, anti-frizz, oil control, reduced brassiness, and volumize, and scent-wise, I went with all eucalyptus. I feel like since using Function of Beauty, my hair just overall feels a lot healthier, and I feel like my hair is just a lot more voluminous than it used to be, and it also doesn't get as greasy looking as quickly. But the really exciting thing though is that they just launched the world's first customizable body care. And for that, all you have to do is just take a 1-minute quiz to customize your own body wash and lotion. I've really been enjoying both the body wash and the lotion, mainly because I'm obsessed with the scent, which is the rose one, if any of you guys are curious. But even in terms of just making the formula, I really like that I got to choose my skin type, which is really dry. And I've found that as I've been using these, my skin has been feeling a lot more soft and hydrated. And what's great is that Function of Beauty products have no parabens, sulfates, GMOs, or toxins, and they're 100% vegan and cruelty-free. They also offer a subscription service where you can get your custom formula delivered on a schedule of your choice, and you can cancel that subscription at any time if you want, or you can change up your formula or the scent of your product or even the color, which personally, I've been having a lot of fun with changing the colors every time that I get a new order. So if you wanna check out Function of Beauty's hair care or body care products, you can follow the link below to get 20% off of your first order. Thanks again to Function of Beauty for sponsoring. Again, if you are interested, definitely check out the link in the description box below. But otherwise, let's get into the video. The first person I thought we should actually check out is Erica Costell, who I think kind of started out as an Alyssa Violet replacement. So she was actually with Jake for quite a while. They did a lot of music videos together, and they actually also went on tour together, which while I was kind of researching for this video, I found this clip, which I just feel like we all need to collectively watch together.
He's kind of cute, but nah,
don't be a sissy and sack up and ask her, dude. You got this, Jake.
Oh my God, he's about to ask me. No.
I was wondering if we could go on a date sometime. Yeah.
I'm sure the Jake Paul meant for that whole intro thing to be astronomically less lame than it turned out to be, but it just looks like two grown adults acting out like a musical script, but it was written by a 9-year-old. He's like infatuated with this idea of appearing like some sort of rap star, like he has interludes and these weird rap music videos, but it all doesn't fit because it's like if Bodak Yellow was released by the Wiggles. Like, it doesn't make any sense. Your audience is 9. But judging by that interlude, it seemed like they were a pretty rock solid couple. Unfortunately for us though, we can't see any more current interludes from Erica and Jake because they did end up breaking up and she left Team 10 in 2018 shortly after. Now I'm gonna be honest, considering that she had left Team 10 so far after they had hit their peak as a group, I wasn't really expecting her to be up to much right now. Like maybe a FabFitFun sponsorship every season. Very, I was a contestant on The Bachelor-esque, but it actually turns out she's been up to quite a lot since she left Team 10. For starters, it seems like she's really pursuing music and she's been dropping singles and music videos since she left the group.
I can't even think about you cause I'm numb.
Ooh, numbness.
Yeah, we're numb. I feel so numb right now even though I can't feel anything because I'm numb.
Beyond music, she's also signed to a London agency for modeling, and even beyond music and modeling, she's actually recently started her own record label. It actually just launched this year, and it's called Bia Entertainment, and the whole motto for it is that it's run by women for women. I tried to see if they were representing any artists currently, or if they were trying to sign anybody, but it seems like right now everything is just coming soon. And on top of all that, she still runs her YouTube channel, and she posts on there pretty frequently. It's definitely not as consistent as it was when she was a part of Team 10, like, you're not gonna see daily vlogs or even weekly uploads, but considering what she has on her plate right now, it's pretty frequent. I actually think it's kind of nice that she still uploads on there for her fans, even though they just relentlessly comment, "I miss Jerrica" on every single one that she uploads, which sounds like a nightmare, but it's still nice of her to do. Next, we have Miss Tessa Brooks. The competition is shook. So Tessa actually also left in 2018, and shortly after she had left Team 10, she had started a dance series with Awesomeness TV. The series was called Dream Dance, and from what I've seen Awesomeness TV produce, I was kind of expecting like a reality show, like maybe they had a dance competition thing where Tessa was one of the judges, and it was like an elimination kind of thing, but it turned out to be the complete opposite of that. The show wasn't actually any type of reality show, it was actually just a dance cover series starring Tessa where she'd like dance to a different song in this white room, and there'd be lights going like this. The series did technically make sense for her, but I'm just kind of surprised that Awesomeness TV didn't do the reality show kind of spin, because I feel like that would have just attracted a lot larger of an audience, because it's just obviously longer form content, and I feel like it just would have shown more of her personality, but maybe people just wanted to see her dance as well. I feel kind of bad though, because it's quite clear that Awesomeness TV was using those dance covers as like an ad for their channel, because the comments on some of these dance covers are so clearly from people that are the furthest from Tessa Brooks' demographic.
This is what Bella Thorne sees when she tries. My brain cells when I see a hard map. I considered buying premium just so I could get this goddamn Tessa. What exactly are you going to do with your arms?
Day 33. Yes. Stone recommendations.
How much do I have to pay for this ad to stop appearing?
Oh no, put the fish back in water.
Notice how casual she is while having a stroke.
The dancing personally to me does not look bad at all, but I'm also like the last person that can have an opinion on this, because during quarantine, one of my goals was to like learn the wannabe shoulder dance. And I just keep almost dislocating my shoulder. She like does this. Since then though, it seems like she's just laying low and she's pursuing dance. She does upload sometimes on YouTube. It's not frequent whatsoever, but when she does upload, it's either like a beauty or lifestyle video or a dance cover. And it does look like she's trying to like pursue IGTV and make special content just for that platform. So it seems like she's focusing mainly on Instagram and dance right now. Next we have Chance Sutton and Anthony Trujillo. Never fallen off like Mag who? Who are you? Dare I say Team 10 who? I'm actually going to be combining them because after they both left in 2018, they've basically been going along the same route together. So the two of them actually have a YouTube channel together and it has over 2 million subscribers and it hosts this atrocity. Hear you talking that shit, got the cruise on bitch, got the whip on cruise, team always on the news. But other than that, it seems like they've just left that channel to collect dust, and instead they've actually moved to Twitch, where both of them have their own separate channels, and they either play games or do just chatting segments. I will say though, the only thing that really separates Chance's post-Team 10 journey from Anthony's is his very unique Twitter presence. To be someone who gets to know information, you must be someone who knows how to handle information. Why are you tweeting like Liam Neeson? He also has this gem that says, you can't get coronavirus if you don't get checked for coronavirus. And you know what they say? You can take the kid out of Team 10, but you can't take Team 10 out of the kid. Moving on, we have the Martinez twins next, and out of the group of people we're talking about today, they're the ones that actually left the earliest back in 2017. They uploaded those 24-hour challenge-style videos on their channel for a while, as well as like prank videos, but then they stopped posting on YouTube for about a year until 2 months ago when they posted a music video for a new song. Beyond uploading the music video, they have also uploaded a short film trailer, and the short film is called The Flu, and it's about the pandemic that's kind of still going on right now. This is like if James Cameron had released Titanic while the Titanic was still sinking. Hey guys, I know this is all really tragic, but get a load of this. But overall, it seems like they're really leaning into the music career thing. They have another song and music video coming out according to their Instagram that's called La Daita. Now the next member we're gonna be talking about is by far, personally for me, the one that I was the most curious about in terms of like what they've done post Team 10, and that's none other than the owner of England, Nick Crompton. Nick Crompton was actually pretty vocal about being the backbone of Team 10, and during the Shane Dawson documentary on Jake Paul, which I did not watch because I know a circle jerk when I see one, he had apparently mentioned to Shane that he was working with a new group after he had split from Team 10 in 2018. After hearing that through the pipeline, I was always kind of curious what social media group he was talking about and which one he was involved in. And I started to actually wonder if he was involved in one of the TikTok houses, because from when the TikTok houses started popping up and when Team 10 ended, that period of time, there was no other social media group really coming out, so I felt like there was no other option for him to like be a part of other than a TikTok group. So part of me wondered if maybe he was just working in the background this time around instead of front and center in a music video claiming a country was his city. But it turns out that he's actually completely out of social media now. If you go to his YouTube channel, it's completely wiped. His Instagram is clearly being used as like a personal Instagram now. And in terms of new ventures, it actually seems pretty quiet on his end. And that might be because he is now, and I'm gonna read this directly because I can't believe it when I say it either, he's actually working at Universal Music Group as the Senior Director of Global Content and Artist Strategy. What the fuck? The degree of confusion in my head right now. I am so confused on so many different levels, but I will say that something that I'm really curious about is what happened to that social media group he had mentioned that he was working with post Team 10. Because the video that he mentioned it in was posted by Shane in October of 2018, yet he apparently started working at Universal a month later. So either the group tanked within a month, or maybe they tanked between the time that Shane had been editing the video in the first place, but either way, it does not seem like that group exists anymore, or maybe they didn't even really exist in the first place. In general though, wow. Like, this is not what I was expecting whatsoever. You know what, Nick Crompton? Maybe England is your city after all. The next member of Team 10 we're going to be talking about wasn't actually a member of Team 10 at the same time as the rest of these members, but he was the only other Team 10 member that I was curious in seeing what they've done since leaving Team 10, and his name is Justin Roberts, which you may not recognize the name, but you probably recognize this clip. 6 figures I was only 4. Yeah, That guy. So it turns out that he didn't actually leave Team 10. He was kicked out in 2019, and since then, in terms of posting, he hasn't posted anything on YouTube since this video that was uploaded over a year ago that, for some reason, stars Jordan Woods. It's not just YouTube he's been silent on, though, because he also hasn't posted on Instagram since December of 2019, so maybe after getting kicked out of Team 10, he just decided to leave social media altogether, or maybe he just got grounded. The final member we're going to be talking about today is none other than the leader of Team 10, and that's Jake Paul. I think it's safe to say that Jake definitely has his work cut out for him when it comes to trying to revive Team 10, because that group has been an utter mess for years now. His most recent attempt to rebuild Team 10 was a little over a year ago with a series called Team 10 Uncut, where it followed Jake as he attempted to rebuild the team with new members through auditions and meetings and stuff like that, all shot in a standard reality show format, except it was unbelievably boring. From there, he built what was supposed to be the new and improved Team 10, which lasted about 10 minutes before royally falling apart. It seems like as of now, there's not a single member of Team 10 that had been pulled from that show and brought onto the team that is still a member of Team 10 today. Except for a small child that doesn't have the autonomy to leave the group, even if they wanted to. Which is always a good sign. Since all those new members left, the Team 10 Instagram page has been dead since September of 2019, and their bio currently reads, "Who will leave next? Stay tuned." Since Team 10 isn't working like it used to, it seems like Jake Paul has been working overtime to be as controversial as possible to stay relevant. For one, he got married to Tana Mojo and has been using her to draw attention to his main channel and get views for his Team 10 channel. And also, in general, his channel has just gotten a lot more sexual in terms of the content, even though his audience is still crazy young. And even though Team 10 isn't big anymore, it seems like Jake Paul's trying to continue on their legacy of landing in the news for doing incredibly dumb shit. Now, some of you guys might be thinking, Team 10 must be over now. The numerous attempts to revive it continue to become bigger failures than the ones before it. Newer content houses are popping up everywhere, giving creators more options than there were back in 2017. And it seems like Jake Paul can handle pissing off the universe all on his own these days, so who needs team members? Apparently still Jake Paul, because in 2020, I'm not kidding, he has mentioned that he's trying to rebuild Team 10 again. He confirmed this back in June in one of his vlogs where he had mentioned that he was going to be rebuilding Team 10 and he was looking at email applications that he had received and would be kind of introducing people later on. As of now, it seems like he's decided on two girls and two guys, and they're like a mix of TikTokers and Instagrammers. Now, like me, you might be wondering, who would join Team 10 in this day and age and why? And apparently one of the justifications that came from one of the influencers was, and I quote, "We want to be part of the original content house because you know why? That's legendary." Yeah, I don't know about legendary. Anyways, those are all the Team 10 members that we're going to be talking about today. I know there's definitely a slew of other members that have entered and left what now seems like the revolving door that is the Team 10 house, but I feel like we covered all the big members. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, feel free to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to follow me outside of YouTube, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, which are both Casey Aonso. I also have a second channel, which is more like beauty, lifestyle vlog kind of content. So if you're interested in that kind of stuff, I'll be linking it in the description box below. But otherwise, I really hope that you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next one.